My name is Jim Strouse, and my film is The Incredible Jessica James. I have been to London once for 12 hours, so I never really got a chance to experience the city. I'm in love with London. It's sort of like that. It's funny that it sort of aligns with my film, and that it is where the lead character Jessica James ends up going to London. Sort of like she's a aspiring playwright, and she's sort of getting rejected all over the place, and finally her work is sort of gets noticed by a theater in London. So it I love theater, and I love like how ingrained in the fabric of the of London theater is, and in that respect it's doubly exciting to be here with the film and Sundance. The story is about a young woman in New York, sort of transplanted from Ohio, who is like a lot of young people in New York who have creative ambitions, sort of struggling to make ends meet, struggling to find time to write while, you know, having a life, and just struggling to find her place in the world, kind of romantically and professionally. And really that's what it's about, sort of being young and wanting to, young and ambitious, but not knowing if it's going to work out. And, you know, at its heart, it's also a romantic comedy. There's sort of, there's a lot of, relation. She's trying to get over a breakup, and that's part, and I wanted to explore what it's like, breakups in this new age of social media, and how they can linger a little longer sometimes. The sort of heartbreak, and when you're broken up with someone but still like friends with them on social media, it's a strange situation. And I wanted to work that into the story a little bit, but honestly, the whole thing was kind of constructed to give Jessica Williams some fun stuff to do, because I'm such a fan of hers. Well, I first became aware of Jessica when she went to The Daily Show in the States with Jon Stewart. I think she was like 22 at the time. And I was I'd been a fan of The Daily Show forever. I think it's such a great place for comedic talent. I mean, obviously, a lot of great actors have come out of The Daily Show, but you know, I think if you see any of her segments on The Daily Show, it's sort of all right there from the beginning. How just sort of engaged and electric she is on screen with the camera, but then like the stories that she was attracted to and they sort of put her on were really interesting, kind of like millennial stories, kind of like about young, sort of addressing the young millennial state in America. You know, watching her on The Daily Show was kind of like, oh, this is, she's changing the show. She's bringing something really new and fresh into it. And that was exciting to watch as a fan of that show. And I just wanted to, it really began from that, wanting to, just being so inspired and excited by her presence and her mind on that show, and like wanting to create something for that talent. Story is set in New York, and I've lived in New York for almost 20 years. The story is actually, most of the characters in the movie are from other places, because that's my experience of New York. Finding a native New Yorker is kind of like a unicorn. There's so many transplants. But I've been there long enough that I felt comfortable. The New York that's represented in the film is the New York that I have experienced myself, and I feel like even down to the theater the children's theater organization that's depicted in the film is a real place called the 52nd Street Theater Project in Hell's Kitchen, a place that I took my kids to watch performances. It's all very personal to me, every sort of location and area in it. So I avoided depicting New York for a long time because I didn't feel like I knew it well enough to kind of try to tell a story about New York. But I've been there 20 years. I have two kids. My kids are bona fide New Yorkers. I felt ready. I was like, well, I here's my little corner. Here's what I love about the city and what I'd like to put on film. I wanted to make something sort of going into it. I told our producer, I want people to watch this movie and then won't go out dancing. I want them just to feel good. I want them to feel like, I want to make something that, you know, feels like it has some emotional heft to it. You know, it's not completely without sort of pain and sorrow, but ultimately, like, you walk out of the theater feeling good. I'd hope that any audience anywhere sort of leaves feeling better than when they came in.